If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are going to be working with our authenticated users. The way it stands right now, a user can register, a user can log in, they can make a purchase, they can do whatever they want, but the billing details aren't quite connected to those authenticated users yet. So that's what we're going to work on today. Let's head into the text editor. Before we get started today, I do want to make a couple of changes. The first thing is in the user model. Right now, our billing detail is singular, and it makes a little bit more sense to have it as billing details instead. So I'm going to make that change there. And the other part that we have for this is the database seeder, and we'll just change it there as well. So let's go ahead and remigrate this database. Everything was successfully seeded and remigrated. So let's go ahead and check the database. Go ahead, refresh that, and just check on our billing details. Okay, everything is just fine. So the seeders are all set. Let's go back and get the rest of it set up. So we're actually going to start this from the back end. And what we need to do first is head over to the app actions, fortify, create new user, and just head down a little bit. So this is a default setting for when a user gets created. We have their name, their email, password. There are terms which we can use. We haven't set that up, and I don't think we're going to, but we might. It's there if you want to use it. This information, we're not putting this information into the users table. This information, again, is going to be in the billing details table. So we can go ahead and just start customizing this a little bit more. The first thing I want to do is I want to change this max to 100. You don't have to do this. This is a personal preference. And the min will just make that a 3. When they register, they have to have at least 3 characters in their name and their email. Under all of this default stuff, we can add the address. And for the validation, we'll say it's required. We'll keep it as a string. And again, min 3. Max of 50. And we'll just copy and paste this. So the next will be city. It will also be a string. The min will be 2, and the max will be, we'll just say 20. Then we need the state. The min will be 2, and the max of 20. The last thing we need on here is the zip code. This will be a min of 5. And a max of 15. And the reason I'm putting the max of 15 is because in the US, some of the zip codes have extra digits. So it's 5 digits, and then it's usually a dash, and then there's another 4 or 5 digits depending on where you live. So I think a max of 15 is pretty reasonable. Instead of returning the user here, we're going to create a variable, and we're going to say user equals. We'll come down here and we'll say user billing details. Remember, because we have that relationship already. And then we're going to create. And then here, I'm just going to copy these. And then they're all going to have input. Just paste those in there. And then we'll add a comma to the end of all of that. The way it works is the validation is going to pass in all of the input fields. The user is a variable where we create the user. Once that user is created, we're basically going to attach the billing details to that user and then create it in the database as a new role. After this, we need to return user. Fantastic. Now, when we update the user, we're going to go to update profile, update user profile information. We're actually just, I can just copy all of this right here. Well, no, because I do need the other field. So copy. I'll just go ahead and paste it here. Okay, and the name. Okay, and the email. We're going to say rule unique. Let's move this up. For this, we'll use this, but the max will be, we'll just change this. Okay, so we have our min, our max, and then we'll just keep that same rule. Now we can get rid of this, and then this password we don't need, and the terms we don't need. Everything here is pretty much the same. Head down, It's also looking for the email. That's fine. That's fine. And now we have a user force fill. We're also going to do user billing details force fill. We'll grab this from here. Okay, so it'll be city, address, city, state, zip code. Fantastic. And then we can copy this one, and I should probably make sure that's spelled correctly here. Okay, so copy. And then under this update verified user, we can do the same thing. Fantastic. Okay, so that's all for the registration and updating information that we need. We're mostly going to focus on the back end for today, and we'll see how far we get. So let's head into the controller. The checkout controller. And then we'll head down to the store method. We already have a property for a user. But what we need to do here is we're going to say auth user or new user. So it'll be either or. Fantastic. The other thing that I want to do is I want to take this validation right here and I want to extract it into a form request. And the reason for that is we're going to have some more information in this, and this will help keep our controller nice and tidy. If we go into the terminal, so it's PHP Artisan, make request, and then we're going to call it checkout form request. Okay, and as you can see here, we have a new folder for requests. Let's go ahead, open that up. And then I'm just going to copy this out of here. And now for this authorize, you have to make sure that this is set to true. And the next part we need are the rules, which we can go ahead and paste in here. Now that we have some sort of distinction between an auth user and a guest user, we're going to have a variable here for email. And this variable is going to be if auth user, and then we'll just grab this stuff right here, paste that in. If it's not, then we'll have all the rest of this. Okay, which means that now we can take this and just use the variable. The reason for this is that an auth user, we just want to make sure that it's very basic. So it's required a minimum of 8, maximum of 100, just like we have in our create a user. We want the same validation. But if it's not an authenticated user, we want to make sure that when they are created, that they're unique to the users table. And that's the only real difference between the two. We're just setting ourselves up for having guests check out. Now I want to have a custom message for this. And all it's going to say is, would you like to sign in? So now we can head back to the controller. And we can go ahead and use that checkout form request. We'll put it right here. And then here, we'll just change this to HTTP requests checkout form request. That clears up that whole line. That's all we need to validate the user without having the validation actually in the controller. It is calling it through the function though. So now I want to try the validation for when the user has the same email address. So we can go ahead and click form filler and let's grab a user's email. Okay, and then let's replace what form filler gave us. And then let's go ahead and add the card. Okay, go ahead, pay now. Okay, so would you like to sign in? And now you can either log in, register, or what have you. So now that all of this is set up, we need to head down to the inertia pages, the view pages. So resources.js, and this will be in pages, auth. So the first one we're going to deal with is the register page. Let's go and see what it looks like right now. Okay, we'll go to the register link. This is pretty much what it looks like now. So don't forget, we want our styling, we want our things on here. So we're going to customize this. So instead of using all of this here, I'm just going to paste it and then we'll go through what everything is. Okay, let's head up top. Let's make sure to bring that up. And let's take a look. Okay, so we have the app layout. We have the title for register. We've got some styling on here. It's pretty much the same thing. We just have our own styling for it. So we have a city, we have the address. All of this information will be what's coming in through the, will be what's coming in through the request. And then we also have our links. So the login, and then we don't have a guest checkout page yet, but we will. I left it as a hashtag. And then we have a link to our shop page saying, would you like to just continue shopping? Okay, and these are all of our imports. This is our form with all of the details that we're requesting from the user. This is our submit method that's going to post this to the backend. Let's take a look and see what that looks like now and see if we might have broken anything. Oh, that looks a lot better. Okay, so we still have our navigation in here, which is all good. Looks good. So why don't we try to see if this works, and let's see if we get any kind of errors. Okay, so password, street address, that's fine. Okay, let's go ahead, register. Ah, we were registered. We went straight to the dashboard. Fantastic. It brought us back to the dashboard, which is great. That means we have already registered and we're logged in. And that's the default settings with the Laravel installation that we did. We already have our authentication set. We're just making some changes to it. So now let's go ahead to the login page and do the same thing. Okay, I'm just going to take all of this out. Going to go ahead and paste in a bunch of things. Okay, and again, this is our styling. It's pretty much the same styling. We have a status, we have our email, password, we have our remember me functionality, we have our links, can reset password, all of that good stuff. And we're using the jet buttons for that. Again, check out as a guest. We have our imports, components, can reset, email, password, remember. Okay, we have the submit method with the remember me and the login. So let's go see if that's working. I just want to take this user's, we don't have a button for that just yet, but let's go to the user profile. So I just want to copy this out and we'll go ahead, log out. We'll go back to the login page, paste that in, password. And then we can also click remember me, login, redirected to the dashboard. We are currently logged in. Let's check the database and make sure that that remember me was checked. So if we go to the users table, and I don't remember how many we made. I think we made 10. So I'm just going to put it in reverse so we can see it. Okay, so this is the email. We haven't verified the email. We don't have that set up, but we do have the password. And our remember token has been successfully input. Fantastic. The other thing I want to check is our billing details, because that's something that we've just set up. So let's go back to the main area, go to billing details. Okay, and this was that user. So we have her address, city, Rhode Island. And if we click that, that should take us right back to that user. Willa Farrell, long email. Password right back to that user. Fantastic. So we have successfully set it up so that the user can register and log in and create billing details for that user. But there is something that I do want to change. Let me copy this again. And then let's log this user out, because I don't want the user to go straight to the dashboard once they've logged in. I want them to go back into the store. The way we do that is if we go to our, might be better for me to just look for it, the root service provider. Right now, this is automatically set to dashboard. This is the path when a user registers or logs in. So I just want to change this to shop. And that should be all that we need. Let's go and give this a try. Okay, we'll go ahead, log in. Okay, so now we're on the shop page. Because I reseeded the database, but I didn't put any products in there. That's fine. As a sanity check, I'm just going to reseed everything and then try it again. First, we need to go to the database seeder. Okay, and we'll uncomment all of these out. Open this up. And then I'm going to drop this. Let's check it out now. Go ahead, refresh. We'll register a user. And let me grab this email real quick. Okay, so now we're at the shop page. All of our items are back. Crisis averted. Let's try it with the logout page as well. I'm sorry, the login as well. Back to the shop page. Fantastic. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave links in the description, including the playlist, so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.